Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the relation between KC and KP, and we have derived an equation on that also. And based on that we are going to talk about the numerical based on that equation. So let us talk about it. So this is a numerical which is based on KC and KP, and that is the problem number one, and this is what we have to calculate. That is, we have to calculate KC as well as KP for the reaction that has been given below at 295 Kelvin. And if the equilibrium concentrations are been given for N2O4 is been given as 0.75 molar, and that of the concentration of NO2 is given as 0.062 molar. And in this case, the value of the gas constant or the R is also been given as 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. So this is the thing that they have been provided to us, and we have to calculate, that is KC and KP. So let us calculate. So before understanding that how can we calculate, it is very essential for us to understand that what would be the formula. So let us understand the formula first. So talking about KC, this is what we have did in our previous lecture also. It is nothing but it is the ratio of the product of the concentration of the product raised to the stoichiometry. So that is concentration of C raised to C into concentration of D raised to D, and it is a ratio that is here I could represent as A raised to A and B raised to B. But talking about the above, that is the question that has been given to us, and the reaction that is basically N2O4, which is of gaseous state, and that is giving us, that is 2 times of NO2 or 2 moles of NO2, and the stoichiometry has also been given over here. And this is what the reaction is, and it is in chemical, it is in equilibrium. So if I talk about how can we calculate the KC, then it is very much easy to understand. Suppose this is what we have, that is to evaluate the value of KC. So this is the product that we could consider. So the product has a stoichiometry of 2, so but we are concerned with that of the concentration of NO2. But since the stoichiometry is also been necessary to mention over here, so therefore the stoichiometry or the number of moles of the product or the NO2 in this case is 2. So therefore this concentration NO2 raised to 2. So this is the only product that we have divided by, that is the concentration of the reactant in this case. Suppose we can consider this also as a reactant. So we could consider that as concentration of N2O4 raised to 1, because the stoichiometry of this is 1. So I could write it over here as it is. So let us fulfill the values over here, because the concentration of NO2 has also been provided to us. So I could write this equation as, that is the concentration of NO2 that has been given as basically 0.062, and this is the square that we have to do. And talking about the concentration of N2O4, that has been given as 0.75. So this is the thing that we have, and after calculation let us see what is the thing that we could get. So we have got a value of, that is 5.12 into 10 raised to minus 3. So this is the value that we have got over here. So therefore I could write the above, that is the value, that is KC is being found to be, that is 5.12 into 10 raised to minus 3. But if I am talking about the units, so let me talk about the unit also. So let me talk about units. So the concentration of the product, that is we have got as molars. So therefore I could write it as, this is the molar for, or that is the moles per dm cube. And talking about the another, because we are squaring it, so again I can write it as molar square or moles per dm cube square. And here also there is molar, so if I cancel out this one, so the value of KC, that is what we could get, is basically molar. So even this we could consider. Usually what happens is we consider the unit of the constant as unitless, but this could be unitless, but if we follow the law of mass action, then this is what we will get the unit. So let me consider this also. So now let us talk about the another one that I was talking about, and that is KP. But how can we calculate the KP? So now talking about KP, so we have a relation between KC and KP, and that is what we have, that is KP, which is equals to, that is KC into RT, that is raised to delta N. So this is what we have, where R is the gas constant, T is the temperature in which the reaction has occurred, and delta N is basically the difference between the number of moles of gaseous product and the number of moles of the reactants. So this is what we have, and let us understand that what was the reaction. So the reaction that was being provided to us, it was basically that is N2O4, and that was giving us basically 2 moles of NO2 and the both pair of the gaseous phase. So if we are talking about this one, the value of R is known, the value of T is also known to us, and what will be the value of N? So it is very easy to estimate. That is, if I'm talking about the number of moles of the gaseous reactant, so in this case the N1 is what I could get is as 1. But talking about the N2 means the number of moles of the gaseous product, and in this case basically N2 has been found to be 2. So we know that delta N is nothing but N2 minus N1. So if we calculate this thing, then 2 minus 1, this, which is nothing but 1 itself. So this is what we have, and the only thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the values over here, and now we can easily calculate the value of Kp. So let us substitute the value over here and let's see what is we could get. So to find Kp, the value of Kc that we have estimated recently, it has been found to that is 5.12 into 10 raised to minus 3 moles. So that is what we have got. And talking about the formula, so in this case basically we could write it in this way. That is talking about the R value or the gas constant. So the gas constant which was being provided to us, it is basically 0.082 liter per atmosphere, liter atmosphere Kelvin per mole. And this is what we have, and the temperature that was being provided to us is basically 295 Kelvin. So I will write it over here as 295 Kelvin raised to 1, means raised to delta. That is what we have. So this is the thing that we have, and we can easily substitute the values over here, and we could write the above equation as this one also. That is 5.12 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 0.082 multiplied by 295. So this is what we have, and the only thing that we have to do is we have to calculate. So let us calculate this thing and let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of that is 0.123. So this is the value that we have got for Kp, and that's it. This is how we can calculate. But talking about the unit also, let me talk about the unit. So now let us talk about what would be the unit of Kp. So 5.12 into 10 raised to minus 3, that was in molar, and molar can be written as that is moles per dm cube, or I would write it in this way. So talking about this value of R, that is what we know is given as basically liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. So the liter can be written as dm cube itself, and talking about the next thing is atmosphere per Kelvin, I would write it over here as per Kelvin. And the per mole can be also written as in this way. So this is what we have, and let us do the further thing. So in this case basically this one would get cancelled out, and the only thing that will be left with us is basically atmosphere per Kelvin. So this is the unit of the Kp. So this is what we do. So that's it, friend. That is what I want to talk about, and here we have estimated the value of Kc as well as the value of Kp using the formula also that we have did in our previous lecture. So I hope you have got this one. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have also got an idea that how can we estimate the unit. So share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.